Welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to authenticate with MongoDB Atlas Cloud Database through X.509 certificate. MongoDB Atlas provide multiple options to authenticate the user with the database. The basic one is through credential and another one is through X.509 certificate. Let me show that. Okay, if you go into this database access, so you can see here, you can add new user. You can see here two options. One is like password, another one is certificate. So either one of the option you can use it. So when you use a certificate, you can authenticate the user with the certificate, no credentials are required. So the X.509 certificate based authentication only works with the M10 plus cluster. If you see here, it will work with only M10 plus clusters. So the M10 plus clusters will not comes under free tier. So we need to pay for that. So again, anyway, it is a cloud based, so pay as you use. Like we can pass the cluster whenever we are not using, or even we can terminate it. But if we are passing the cluster will be re-enabled after 30 days. If you are not doing any operation or we are not enabling it within 30 days, automatically it will be re-enabled. But if you are terminating, it will be completely terminated. So I have a cluster based on M20. So let me show that. Yeah, I have two cluster. One is a normal one. This is M10. I'm not sure which based, yeah, M0, so another one is, this one is M20 based cluster, if you see M20 general. So I have a sample database created here. Okay, the database name is test M20, then I have a collection, sample collection, again test M20, then I have a document, there is a field called test field 1 and the value is test value 1. So let us now create a user. So for that I will go into the database access. So it will be enabled with X.509 certificate based authentication. So I will go into the certificate. I'm going to give some CN equal to test user. So here you can select this download certificate when user is added. So also you can the certificate expiry date, you can select 3 months, 6 months. So until then the user will be able to access. So let me go 3 months now. Then you select what kind of access level this user should be having. So either it can the user can be admin or read and write or only read only. So I'm going with read and write, I'm fine with that. So now, yeah, that's remaining things are fine. I'm clicking on a add user. So once the user is added, this will download the certificate, PIM certificate. So keep it safe because this will have the private key. Through the private key, we are going to connect to the database. So who are having this private key, they will be able to access the database provided the IP address is whitelisted. Okay, let me copy this into... Okay, I'm going to copy here. Something else already, I will delete this. Okay, now we have configured the user and download the PIM certificate. So now we need to convert this PIM certificate into the private key, mainly the private key into the JKS format. So let us do that first. So let me show you the commands that should be executed. So this is the first one. I am using the OpenSSL. Converting the PKCS, first I am converting this PIM to PKCS 12. So from then PKCS 12, I am converting into JKS format. So I'm exporting, this is my input certificate, the certificate name, I need to change it now. This is the PIM certificate. Now converting this into a PKCS certificate. Let me go into a command prompt. Let me execute this. It will ask you a password. So any password you can enter. So this password is required while you are connecting from the client. Okay. Now if I go into this folder, so keystore.pkcs 12 is created. Now this PKS, PKCS certificate, 12 certificates will be converted into JKS. This command can be used. So here this is the input, the PKCS 12 format, like then this is the output or destination key store. Keystore.jks file will be created, then with the type of the destination store type is JKS. Okay, let me copy this command. Okay, yeah, we need to enter the password here, destination password, then one, then we even the source password, what are the password you earlier given while converting into PKCS 12. So okay, now if you go into this folder, the keystore.jks is created. So now I have a small I'm going to connect from Java. So I have a small program to connect to the Mongo cluster through x.509 certificate. So let me show that. Okay. Yeah, so here I am just, what I am doing is I am connecting to the Mongo cluster, then like I am just executing a query to find out a specific document. So from the specific database, test M20 and test M20. So obviously like, you can get this connection string from here. Go into the clusters, connect. Yeah, connect your application. In my case, it's Java. Then 3.6 or later, you can connection string only or full driver example you can copy from here. So now here, if you see like there is a admin password, but this we can change it later. So then some query parameter. So I already copied that. So now here one difference is like I'm using the Mongo client URI, the same URL whatever copied from there, but you need to add some additional parameters to this URL to enable the x.509 authentication. So one is like auth mechanism, then it should be mongodb-x509, then auth source, it should be dollar external. So these two parameters should be enabled or added to enable the x.509 based authentication. And also the username should be removed. If you see here, like I removed the username and password. So just mongodb plus srv colon double slash, then the host name. The another one is we need to set this system properties. So one is like javax.net.ssl.keystore. So this is the final keystore file what we created. So it is keystore.jks. So second thing is keystore password. So I given the password as welcome one. So whatever the password you are enabling, we need to keep it here. So then next all like a symbol like database, we are getting the database. Then first we are creating the connection through URI. Based on that URI, then we are getting the database collection. Then I'm querying based on the ID. I'm getting the first record. So anyway, there is a one record. So then I'm fetching this value. Field one, the value of the field one. Okay, now let me now execute this. Okay, yeah, I'm able to see the data test value one. So this is the value corresponding to that specific field. Test field one. If you see here, nowhere I given the credential to connect. So even the username or anything I did not provided. I only just provided this key store, where is my private key or private key installed, and then what is the password to connect to that key store. Then I enabled some extra query parameter saying like what is my auth mechanism and auth source. So yeah, I'm able to successfully connect to the cluster through this x.509 certificate without any credentials, specifying any credentials. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.